He hears a loud pop sound. It is the sound of his hamstring popping off of his leg. Instantly, he hits the track right on the ground, and you start to see tears coming from his face. His vision was to be an Olympic medalist, and he broke the British record. He qualified for the Olympics in 1988, won a world championship with his team. He's favored to be a medalist at the Barcelona Olympics, and he's on the track preparing for the first event. He's running faster and faster, building momentum, building confidence, building belief in himself that he is capable of achieving his childhood dream. He's out leading the pack, and all of a sudden, after about 150 meters, he hears a loud pop sound. And this sound is the sound of his hamstring popping off of his leg and ripping his hamstring. And instantly, he hits the track right on the ground, and you start to see tears coming from his face. But he can't just get up and sprint, but he has this deep, dark desire inside of him to at least get up and try to finish. He starts hobbling one step at a time, hobbling, just trying to finish and complete what he started with this dream he had. And then a little bit farther, as he keeps going, you see a man sprinting down from the stadium, the Olympic arena. No one's allowed to come down on the track, and someone gets through security, pushes through the audiences, and comes to the rescue of this runner. This runner's father sprinted down and carried him, put his arm around his son, and they continued hobbling together and walking together, and he encouraged him to finish the race. And as they continued down the last 50 meters, they walk to the finish line together, arm in arm, and complete what they started. No matter what happens along our journey, no matter if we get injured, no matter if we have a setback, it's always important to remember that failure is just a bend in the road. It's not the end of the road. And no matter where you're at in your life, just notice, are you bending or do you think it's an end for yourself? And usually it's just a bend. And all you need to do is take the next step and keep moving forward. I don't remember anything else about the 1992 Olympics. I don't remember who won the gold medal that year. I don't remember who broke the world records and other events. I don't remember what else happened during that time. But I remember the story of Derek Redmond and his father. I remember the passion. I remember the pain. I remember what it felt like to see and witness this inspirational moment, this heartache to heroic moment, seeing someone fight for his life to complete what he started, to watch his whole dreams crumble right before him, but not allow it to hold him back from completing what he started.